In the last session, we have seen what is a network. It is a set of communication devices connected by media links. Then we have seen two types of connection, point-to-point connection. Two and only two devices are connected by a dedicated link, and multi-point connection, three or more devices share a link. Then we have seen topology of network. It refers to the physical or logical arrangement of a network. Devices may be arranged in a mesh, star, bus, or ring topology. In this session, we will see different types of networks: local area network, wide area network, metropolitan area network. Then we will see switching techniques and accessing the internet. Local area network, it is privately owned network. It links all the devices in a single office, building, or campus. A simple LAN connection can be two PC and a printer. LAN size is limited to a few kilometers. It allows resources to be shared between personal computers or a workstation. Resources can be hardware, software, and data. And LAN will use one type of transmission medium. Transmission medium is a pathway between the sender and receiver to transfer information in the form of bits. The most common LAN topologies are bus, ring, and star. The speed of local area network are normally 100 or 1000 Mbps. Wireless LAN are the newest evolution in LAN technology. Next, the wide area network. LAN provides a short distance transmission of information, whereas a wide area network provides long distance transmission of data, image, audio, and video information over large geographic areas covering a country or a whole world. There are two types of WAN: switched WAN and point-to-point WAN. Switched WAN connects all the end systems using a router. Router is an internetworking connecting device. It also connects one LAN to another LAN or WAN. Next, a point-to-point WAN. So it is a line leased from a telephone or cable TV provider that connects a home computer or small LAN to an internet service provider. This point-to-point WAN provides internet access. Next, internet network. This diagram shows a heterogeneous network made of four wide area networks and two local area networks. Assume that organization has two offices in two different locations. In one location, local area network follows bus topology. In another location, LAN has star topology. The president of the company lives somewhere in the middle. So he has the control over these two LAN networks. And all these networks and the president's computer can be connected through a switched WAN. To connect LAN to the switched WAN, you need three point-to-point wide area networks. And these point-to-point wide area networks can be a high-speed DSL line offered by telephone company or a cable TV provider. Metropolitan area network. It is a network with a size between a LAN and a WAN. It connects multiple networks within the same city to form a city-wide network for a specific government or industry. It is a network bigger than LAN but smaller than WAN. Example of a metropolitan area network is the part of telephone company network that can provide a high-speed DSL line to the customer. We have seen different types of networks: LAN, WAN, and MAN. Now we will see switching techniques. In large networks, there can be multiple paths from sender to receiver. The switching technique will decide the best route for data transmission. Switching technique is used to connect the systems for making one-to-one communication. Mostly, we have two types of switching techniques: circuit switching and packet switching. Circuit switching. Circuit switching establishes a dedicated path between sender and receiver, which remains to exist until the connection is terminated. When any user wants to send information, a request signal is sent to the receiver. Then receiver sends back acknowledgement to the user to ensure availability of the dedicated path. This is circuit establishment. After receiving acknowledgement, dedicated path is used to transfer data. After all data is transferred, connection is used. After all data is transferred, connection can be terminated. So therefore, the communication through circuit switching has three phases: circuit establishment, data transfer, and circuit disconnect. So this diagram shows the sender A transmits three messages to receiver B using intermediate nodes S1, S2, till S6. This circuit switching technique can be used for voice transmission. Fixed data can be transferred. Packet switching. The messages to be sent is divided into smallest pieces called packets. Each packets were given a unique number to identify their order at the receiving end. Each packet contained header information such as source address, destination address, and the sequence number. Packets take shortest path to travel across the network. All the packets are reassembled at the receiving end in correct order. If any packet is missing or corrupted, then the message will be sent to resend the message. If the correct order of the packets is reached, then the acknowledged message will be sent. So this diagram shows a communication between the sender A and the receiver B. The sender A has one message. It is divided into four packets. These packets take different routes to reach packet B. Receiver B. So these packets are correctly arranged through the sequence number. This packet switching network is more efficient than the circuit switched network, but the packets may encounter some delays. So we have seen two types of switching techniques, circuit switching and packet switching. Next, we move on to internet. So internet is composed of thousands of interconnected networks. This diagram shows three level of networks. The first level is the top level. This top level contains backbones. Backbones are large networks owned by Sprint, Verizon, AT&T. These are connected through some complex switching systems called peering points. Next, the second level of networks are provider networks. These are smaller networks connected to backbones and other provider networks. So it is a paid service. It will pay to the backbone networks. Third level of network is customer networks. So they are edge of the internet that actually use the services provided by the internet. Again, it is a paid service to the provider for receiving services. Here the backbones use international ISP. Provider networks use national or regional ISP. This internet can be accessed using telephone networks, cable networks, wireless networks, or a direct connection to the internet. So first we will see using telephone networks. You can connect to the internet using dial-up service or DSL service. In dial-up service, the modem is added to the telephone line that converts data to voice. So for this, software is installed on the computer that dials the ISP. This one, disadvantage of dial-up service is very slow. It cannot be used for voice communication. It is only useful for small residences. Next, DSL service. It provides high-speed internet services to residences or small businesses using telephone line. In DSL service, you can use both voice and data communication simultaneously. Next, internet access using cable networks. It provides a higher speed connection, but the speed varies depending on the number of neighbors that use the same cable. Next, you can also access internet using wireless network. And you can also have the combination of both wired and wireless connection to access the internet. So for wireless network, you'll be using wireless LAN connection. Next, the direct connection to the internet. Here, the large organization can itself become a local internet service provider and be connected to the internet. So this is done by leasing the high-speed WAN from a carrier provider and connects itself to a regional internet service provider. For example, a large university with several campuses can create an internet network and then connect the internet network to the internet. To summarize this session, a network can be categorized as local area network, wide area network, and a metropolitan area network. A local area network is a data communication system within a building, plant, or campus, or between nearby buildings. A wide area network is a data communication system spanning states, countries, or the whole world. The internet is a collection of many separate networks.